last award will be to be presented to the 2009 Alex Gordon USPTA Professional of the Year. This recipient has been a USPTA Professional One for more than 30 years. He is the director of tennis at the Balsams Grand Resort Hotel in Dixville Notch, New Hampshire, and has served as the chair of the UST Olympic Tennis Committee since 2006. He is a former USPTA New England Division President and has served on the USPTA Executive Committee from 1998 to 2001. He also is currently on the USPTA New England Division Testing Committee. He also is the President of the USTA New England Section and served on several committees, including USTA National Budget Committee, USTA New England Leagues Committee, and the USTA National Executive Committee. Our Pro of the Year is committed to giving back to his community through free lesson days at numerous pro events, including the Pilot Pen in New Haven and the ATP Grass Court Tournaments. He also created and hosted the world's largest free tennis lesson to Girl Scouts at the Pilot Pen and serves as a volunteer coach at the Tenacity Program in Boston. As a player, he has been ranked as high as number 3 by the USPTA in men's open and 35 doubles. He's been ranked as high as number 2 by the USTA in men's doubles. As a coach, he has worked with several WTA-ranked players and world-ranked men's doubles player Matt Palomino. He received the International Tennis Hall of Fame's Educational Merit Award, the USPTA New England Division Pro of the Year Award in 1995 and 2008, and was named 5-time USPTA New England Division Tester of the Year. The 2009 Alex Gordon USPTA Professional of the Year is Robert Greene Jr. of Rangeley. Okay, let's see, you've been sitting here for an hour and a half drinking coffee. I'll try to make this as brief as I can. Thanks very much, it's a great honor to receive this award. I've been involved in tennis for well over 40 years, half of that time spent trying to change my forehand grip from continental to a semi-western. Now that I can't run to the ball anymore, I'm happy to say I'm almost there. It's really quite something to be from New England and to be recognized for this type of an award, because this will put me right up there with the Patriots, the Celtics, and the Red Sox. I would like to make it perfectly clear that I did not secretly videotape the other candidates for this award, nor did I take any steroids. Those were vitamins that Paul Roeder sold me. I guess leadership can be defined as bringing important issues to the forefront in such a manner so that other people will really line up with you on these issues and then move them forward. Now, there have been a few times when I've looked over my shoulder and there's been no one there, but more often than not, there have been a lot of people there, and I also have to say that if I didn't have USPTA after my name, none of what I've accomplished really would have been possible. So I'd really like to, first and foremost, thank the USPTA, and especially Tim Heckler, who has personally supported me on many initiatives, even when I didn't know it. And he has done a fantastic job, along with the board and the staff, of keeping this organization really on the cutting edge of everything that is tennis. Thank you. I'd like to thank Tom McGraw and the awards committee. I know that those of us who submitted applications for all these awards sent you a book about the size of the Bible. So thanks for taking the time to weed through all of that. I have to thank George Bechel, who instilled in me the importance of creating and maintaining the highest standard of excellence possible in tennis teaching and education and certification. And I believe that that is what really separates the USPTA apart from other organizations. I have to thank my partners in the development of the National Tennis Rating Program, especially USPTA Pro Larry Jones,
who wrote the first computer program that was adopted for the NTRP. And I really would like to thank every single USPTA pro who has ever, ever worked as a National Tennis Rating Program verifier. Because those are the people, and a lot of you are in this room. And even though we've all been kind of replaced by the computer system, it is all of those people who have been responsible for growing USPTA league tennis from 300 players in 1979 to well over 500,000. And that's a pretty big accomplishment. I want to thank all my fellow pros in the USPTA New England division who've been supportive. Thank you very much. Especially Avis Murray, Jeff Waters, Dave Fleury, our head tester, and the late Rick Martineau and Bob Blackman. I want to thank USPTA member and founder of Chase Tennis Camps, Neil Chase, and tennis legend Fred Perry, who coached me a little bit, although I didn't live up to his expectations. But I learned a lot about the nuances of teaching high-performance tennis. Everyone at Head Pen, thank you very much, especially Amy Wichengrad, and I really, really, Amy, want to thank you for sending me to Detroit several times in January. That was really a treat. But it was a great pleasure to speak to well over 300 high school coaches. They're very enthusiastic, great group. I have to thank Victoria Quas and Ken Solomon, the Tennis Channel, everyone at the Baltimore Grand Resort Hotel, USTA national leaders, Jane Brown, who trusted me with oversight of the United States Olympic tennis team, and also especially Lucy Garvin, Merv Heller, Sharon Gall, Alan Schwartz, and USTA staffers, Kirk Camperman, Dave Brewer, and Dave Schobel. I want to thank members of the 2007 Pan Am team and the 2008 USA Olympic tennis team. These players go to represent their country. It's not for the money. And it's they really put themselves out to travel for this. I want to especially thank Jill Craigass from Rhode Island, Venus Williams, Lisa Huber, Bob and Mike Bryan, and James Blake, who, by the way, showed phenomenal class and self-restraint in his match against Gonzalez. If he had won that match, he would have been guaranteed at least a silver medal. Also want to thank USTA wheelchair tennis players and gold medalists Nick Taylor and Dave Wagner, who won the gold medal in the quad doubles. And I don't know if you've ever seen some of these wheelchair players play, but they're amazing. Nick Taylor puts the ball between his feet, he pops it up, and then swings and serves it, and his serving percentage is over 70%. It's really phenomenal what these players can do, and that's actually higher than Randy Madden's service percentage. Finally, I want to thank my family, my dad, mom, Kelly, Angela, Doug, and especially Heather, love to all of you. I'd like to ask my family, thank you for believing in me, but it's more like thank you for putting up with me and all this tennis nonsense over the years, but they've been fabulous. This is a great moment, but at the end of the day, tennis is really bigger than any of us, and we're all lucky to be passing through the game and to be able to have a positive influence and enrich the lives of many tennis players and fellow teaching professionals. It is my great honor to serve this great game of tennis. Thank you very, very much.
I'm going to get this home.